Traffic engineering has three steps: measuring the network to figure out the current traffic loads, forming a model of how configuration affects the underlying paths in the network, and then ultimately reconfiguring the network to exert control over how the traffic flows through the network. An operator might measure the topology and traffic, feed the topology and traffic to a what-if model that predicts what will happen under various types of configuration changes, decide which changes to affect on the network, and then ultimately control the network behavior by readjusting link weights. So in summary, we have measurement, modeling, and control. Each of these three components requires a significant amount of heavy lifting to make both practical and accurate in practice. Intra-domain traffic engineering attempts to solve an optimization problem where the input is a graph, G, where R is the set of routers, and L is the set of unidirectional links. Each link, L, also has a fixed capacity. Another input is the traffic matrix, or the offered traffic load, where Mij represents the traffic load from router I to router J. The output of the optimization problem is a set of link weights, where WL is the weight on any unidirectional link L in the network topology. Ultimately, the setting of these link weights should result in a fraction of the traffic from I to J traversing each link L, such that those fractions satisfy the network-wide objective function. Defining an objective function is tricky. We could talk about, for example, minimizing the maximum congested link in the network, evenly splitting traffic loads across links, and so forth.